Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment. You can listen to The Mike O'Mara Show at MikeOMaraShow.com.
Let's get started.
It's The Mike O'Mara Show with Mike O'Mara, Oscar Santana, and Robb Spiewak. Now, here's Mike.
You see, it's not that he was late to the party with that that annoyed you, Oscar. It's that his solution, when I'm listening to your solutions or your way of working through my little issue, all of them are kind of like, ultimately we'll get to the clear solution.
Right.
Correct, and then Ichabod McDingling weighs in with shake it.
Should we give any background or just let this hang heavy in
the
air?
I'm sorry, I just wanted to finish the thought before the show, Robb. I know we should give some context. What I'm saying is I have an issue with printer streaking, and we were trying to work through it, and I was just taking some tips about let's go here, let's go settings
some
here.
Menus,
and then a disembodied voice from the peanut gallery says, is it a laser printer? And Oscar says, I don't know, is it Mike? I said, yes, it is a laser printer. That's not going to work for that. Just take the cartridges out and shake them.
So,
and he's probably right.
He is correct.
And
it's not that I'm not going to do that after the show, but don't ask me why that was frustrating.
I'll tell you what's stuck in my crawl.
Exactly. Right? And I bet we're the same on this.
Yeah. Was that we have been discussing this printer
issue
streaking for the past 2 weeks.
Right. Yeah, we have.
And the solution was on the other side of this wall.
Yeah.
Saying nothing.
Right. And we thought we had it diagnosed.
Yeah, we're like, online, and I'm like looking up for this HP GUI, and he's like, no, just shake it.
Shake it, baby. Right. One time for me.
He just walked in the room. You could have said this 2 weeks ago.
How's it going, Mike?
Going well. Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Show from Calgary, Canada, Madrid, Spain, Kearney, New Jersey, Timonium, Maryland, Good Grief, Idaho, and Pepee Township in Ohio. The Mike O'Mara Show is on now. There's a lot of my wife in the show today.
Oh.
Because I like my life with my wife. That rhymes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But at the same time, I like to share. And there's nothing really between us. This is how pathetic our lives are. There's nothing really between us that I enjoy more, outside of, the usual, than watching a program, a series of some sort, that's a regular appointment viewing for us together.
Sharing
like
a television
that.
Show is easy, low-level intimacy.
It's great,
thank
and you,
you
know
that's
what?
That's a beautiful sentence. That should be that easy, low-level intimacy. Could not have said it better. See, your English, while you struggle occasionally, then you will blast out a beautifully stated sentence like that. And it's true. So it's so true that I make the decision to go back to the beginning of season 5 of my favorite television show, Yellowstone, me and the rest of the world.
Yeah, we love it.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I go back. But as I put in my show prep today, watching a television program with my wife is unrewarding.
Mm.
It is unrewarding. Now, it might have something to do with the fact that the alarm went off at 5 a.m. yesterday, which is a little earlier than I like to open my peepers when I've gotten to bed at 11:30, quarter or 12. A little frustrating. And it's something that I wanted to do with her, and I really wanted to like it because the female characters in that show are so strong and wonderful.
Yeah.
They're the cornerstone of the show. So, but watching it with a woman who does almost all of her outside of the studio work on her phone at all times, and I see the glow of it at all times.
It's a mobile world,
It frustrates the hell out of me. And then every 8 minutes, Mom. My son.
Mom.
My son. Not me.
Mom.
And it's like, at a certain point, I'm like, why am I even doing this exercise? Because
Is it all work on the phone, or does she ever surf like TikTok or anything like that?
It can be anything.
She's engaging with her customer.
I don't have my idea. Yeah. It can be engaging with one of her friends, one of her male friends from the workout center. No. I don't know what this is. Just kidding.
Me. Male friends.
Who knows, you know? Anyway, so it's like,
do you hear one more rep,
Mrs. O'Mara? So she's there right now. She's not working today, but she's at Burn.
Well, some people would say that is work.
Well, it is. It is. It is, absolutely. And I have been remiss in mine, and I got to get back
Instagram
to it.
Instagram to see what's going on.
Getting back
to it.
You
waste not a moment, do you?
No, I'm on. I know Mike's other gym. I'm not going to mention that. And there's some things going on there. Let me tell you.
That's right.
So it reminds me that the first two episodes of season 5 of Yellowstone are sluggish.
Yes.
In my humble opinion, I validate that by going back and watching it again. And I believe that episode 3 of this season is going to be a kind of a humdinger. I think it is, but I'm not sure. But anywho, here are the rules. We can only watch one at a time.
Okay.
Even if it's wrapping up at 7:30 or 7:40, when we could have easily knocked out two more, because she doesn't do that. Duh. Secondly, constant interacting with my son, who really, you know, should be told, Michael, just get it done, do that, blah, blah, blah. And then third, the glow of the phone. So I'm just saying unrewarding, but I'm not giving up on it.
Does she binge on any television? Is there any show that she'll like really just lock into?
Murder shows, reality murder shows.
Dead husband shows?
Dead husband shows, which you know are all 18 hours long with one episode because they have 17 coming up. And then they'll show you what they just talked about.
Right.
So it's what it is. But I love her. Excuse me. I don't know what I ate this morning. Cliff Bar.
I've caught up on this season, so I'm current.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm current too. I'm current too. And you know that there's a humdinger of a scene in a bar that I really look forward to.
Yes.
And so I'm kind of waiting for that one.
Oh, you haven't even approached the. Oh, that's a hooker.
Well, I hope so.
Yeah,
because
it's
delightful. Yeah. It's giving me the meat that I wanted out of that. And the one thing that won't hook her, pardon the pun, is the new Pit Viper that they bring in from the corporation.
Oh, no, that's
right.
That hooked you and me.
That's a problem.
Immediately.
Yeah.
That hooked
us. Because we can't have that conversation.
That is someone I would. Isn't it weird, though? There are younger, more model-like celebrities out there. Yeah. But that's a woman I would love to see
she's
in person.
She's a certified dream killer.
She truly is.
Yeah.
And she's a magnificent actress on top of it, as well as looking. And
Do you think watching TV with her would be rewarding?
I would not care.
That was the right answer.
I would say, I'm going to paint that wall. Come sit next to me, and we'll watch it dry.
Yeah.
That's the way. And I'm sorry. And I think when I went back and looked, I said, maybe I overstated it. And then I watched a little more. I said, no, I didn't.
No.
She's not perfect. She's not perfect.
But I think it's bad lighting. Like when she's in... when she's in an Attorney General Dutton's office, there's great lighting.
Yeah,
let me tell you.
Yeah, then there are other ones. But that's the charm of it.
Yes.
So anyway, Oscar and I are talking about that. You watch it, right?
I've watched episode 1 of season 5. I've not caught up yet. It's been busy.
You don't like it.
It's okay. It's not
unpleasant.
It's not your cup of tea.
You know what it is? There is an unpleasantness to it. That's what originally drove me away from Breaking Bad. Now, I eventually liked Breaking Bad, but the first season, it was so unpleasant. Yeah. That it drove me away a little bit.
There's a lot of the first three episodes of the season, they hit you over the head with unpleasantness.
Okay, noted. But I should stay with it.
I think you'll like it.
Okay.
If there's one, and spoiler alert, if you don't want to hear about Yellowstone, don't talk. Spoiler alert, the first two seasons, and I validated this by watching it over again, we get it. We get that you don't want to be governor. We get it. Stop pounding that, okay? We get that, John Dutton. We get that you're a reluctant leader. Blah!
Yeah,
anyway,
there's...
Thank you.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a scene where one of his like advisors said that to him? We get it!
They all do. They all do. And then he just pulls an Elon Musk. Yeah. Spoiler alert.
Exactly.
Oh, dear.
So I just wanted to share that with all of you that...
Is Shannon the same way? Does she live in her phone while you're watching TV?
This is the bit Shannon does. Shannon, like in movies, pretends like she cares, and then all of a sudden, in the middle of the best effort, and I think I've said this before.
Mm. Key dialogue. Yeah,
someone's going to die, or someone is leaving the show after 7 years of us watching it. She'll just walk out of the room.
Yeah. Yep, wow. There it is. It's engagement. Yeah. They don't, they're, look, the bottom line, women are smarter than men. They
yeah,
are.
Sure.
They are. And they are not as easily
sucked
they're
in.
They're not as easily amused as we are. That's what we are easily amused. You can put us down like a toddler, and if we like something, you can sit us down there. We sit there. Think about just a second for all of my fellow NFL fans.
Yes.
Think about the drivel that we have to sit through
know.
To watch again because they know we'll sit on
we're
our
so
fat
quiet,
asses and watch
it's
it.
Like
yes.
It's a final
we're submissive.
Drive. Yep. Tom Brady, this happened. Two touchdowns, 3 minutes.
Right. Yep.
I said, Shannon, I want to talk about this. Just give me 3 minutes. 3 minutes.
Yeah. Right.
I said, he's gonna do this. I have a feeling about this.
Well,
and she's like, keeps
why
talking.
Why can't you talk to me during the
talking.
Commercials? Why because they're going to come back at any particular said, time. They're going to do it.
And I sat there. He came back. He won the game. Right? He was the Tom Brady of old. And I said, what you know what this means? She goes, can we talk about that thing now?
That's all that's on her mind.
Yeah. We will sit. And watch Paul Giamatti as Scrooge and Cecily Strong from Saturday Night Live 75 times during a football game, hawking the same same product with the same commercial. They don't effing care.
No.
They're not
going
to give us new content. They're not going to give us new content. No. They don't have to. We're there. We're a captive audience. We will sit there mindlessly staring at Paul Giamatti with his fake sideburns going, wow.
I've said
2 minutes to go in a game and you're getting an hour and 47 minutes of commercial.
Yeah. I said this to Shannon. I said, I know you don't mean to. But for some reason, I do take it personal when you know I'm
personally.
Thank you. Don't get happy.
Okay.
I do take it personally when you know I'm into something and something clicks in your like inner id. Let me ruin it for him by coming in
passively,
or stomping around.
I'm gonna give counterpoint.
Okay. Can I just give you this example?
Yes,
we're
go
watching
ahead.
Get Out. Remember that fantastic movie
great
in
movie.
The theater right before the pandemic.
Right.
And the big reveal, like it's all happening. And is it popcorn? Is it a hot dog? Is it ketchup? Like all the smells you would have in an environment of a theater.
Right.
And Shannon is putting on the most floral lotion that completely takes you out of your...
In a movie theater?
In the movie theater.
In the dark.
She's
in the dark.
Putting can cream
she's
on.
She's creaming her hands, Mike.
Creaming her hands at the key moment of the
correct.
Yeah.
There it is. They don't need it.
No, they
don't care. They're not. It's visual stimuli is not as relevant to them. It doesn't matter. Listen. They are the superior being.
I agree. Yeah.
Make no mistake about it. It is not. We are watching an image of fake stuff going on a screen, or in the case of football, men smashing their
other
heads
men.
Into one another.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, so I don't know.
Well, it's Carrie, Carrie and I make an effort because we have very little overlap on what we enjoy. And I've tried to watch the 90 Day Fiancé.
In life, right?
Can't do it in anything, Mike. we sleep in shifts. It's like a submarine.
But
there are certain shows that when she expresses an interest, I'll make sure we're together when we watch it.
You're thoughtful.
Case in point right now is White Lotus. We're both enjoying White Lotus.
Okay? That's a naughty show because she's a dirty birdie too. So I bet she likes that.
Well,
show.
I think what it is that it's color. It's a current show. And
what do you mean color?
Because
something
black,
you like that's in color?
Black and white is not what she likes. So
that's why you don't like Yellowstone.
So I put it on and she is in her phone, and then she'll say, I'm tired. I'm going to bed. And I'm not going to fault her for that. She works very hard. She goes to bed. I'll stay up another 45 minutes and I'll go up to the bedroom. And the entire top floor is dark because we're the only ones in the house now. The kids are gone. And she's lit like the Wizard of Oz, laying in bed, looking at her phone.
Carla does.
Yeah. And I said, so it's not that she's tired.
Mm-hmm.
She just wants to surf the web in a different environment, and she is disinterested.
Yeah.
And
they're not held by stuff like we are.
And I'll be watching something that I think it's pretty good, and I think she should be into it, and then I'll hear from the tiny speaker on the other side of the sofa, do-do-do-do-do-do-do, because she's found a dog video, and she's loving it. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do
Yeah. They just, there's a reality element to it. where it's a real dog doing something, and that's the reality. That's why they like more reality TV than we do. I believe this.
Okay.
Now, if you think I'm painting in broad strokes, and you're a woman out there listening to me that's going to get angry, don't get angry. You, on the other hand, I want to focus on your somewhat muted interest in Yellowstone. That's not a show for you. It's not a show for you. It's just not. White Lotus, plenty of intrigue.
Yes.
Plenty of hijinks. Of hijinks.
Hijinks. And, I know that's the
but
word.
I mean, in a way, like Murder on the Orient Express, your bag. Yellowstone, and I mean this in the nicest possible
And Mike,
way.
That's how I'll take it, even before you say it. Go ahead.
That is a guy's show. It's a man's man show.
Yeah.
It's a you know,
and
it's
also
cowboys
Mike, when
and
I
guns
finish
and,
my DVR at One Life to Live, there's so little time.
That's like you know, get her done and come on, get out there. And
no,
shoot
I can appreciate. I can appreciate
like
the genre. It's a modern western. I like westerns okay, but it's just I think there's other
I like
stuff.
That. There it is. I like westerns okay.
But there's modern stuff out there that I appreciate more than Yellowstone. I'm not saying it's
like
a bad
only
show.
Murders in the Building.
Ooh, yeah.
Quirky and
biggest
hijinks.
Show in the history of Hulu. Oh, I'm the only one who likes
Hulu.
It.
I rest my case. The biggest show in the history of Hulu.
Biggest streaming service.
Not bigger than Handmaid's Tale.
That's true.
Okay, so you
it's
win.
It's one of the big dogs,
Yeah. That was another good guy show for
only
you,
Murders in the Building has podcasting. It's got heritage, like old school A-list actors.
Comedy, great
right?
comedy.
It's got Selena Gomez.
And who is just lovely.
Yeah, and I mean, I haven't finished the first season, but I could see the appeal to that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But there's just, I like more reality in my TV.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't like fake crap, and that's all it is.
Yellowstone, is Yellowstone all that real?
Let me tell you why. I'll tell you exactly why. Many, many, many of the extras and cast members on that show are actual cowboys, guys that work on ranches.
Many of the people in Only Murders in the Building are New York residents.
Socialites? Wealthy socialites.
Wealthy socialites in ancient buildings, yeah. So
right. It's a gritty... the casting for Kevin Costner in his later years... is flawless.
Yeah, it's very good.
He's a perfect old curmudgeon, and it's got these ballsy characters. What Yellowstone does, Robb, and is people who love conflict, like yours truly.
Yes,
it allows immediate conflict with no waiting. Yeah. And that's why I lap it up because it's
if something good happens, like I'm not saying there's not even a commercial before something bad immediately happens.
A good balance
it out. It's always usually bad.
Oh, it leans towards bad. Yes. Yeah, okay.
The creator of Yellowstone, a gentleman by the name of Taylor Sheridan, is I want to say this nicely again. If you think of a guy like Taylor Sheridan, he is as kind of the archetype male macho Western guy as you can possibly.
Yeah. He's writing for himself what he knows.
All right, that makes sense.
Yeah, macho guy.
Yeah,
super super.
So
manly.
Not my cup of tea.
It ain't for you. Let's get our talking.
Mike, I'm glad we had this talk. This went well.
You killed me.
Did you? Am I the only one who watched Antiques Roadshow last night?
our talking head. Oh my God! You wrote another novel.
And Mike, this is short. This is short compared.
This is not short.
This is short compared to where we're at. These are all details that are important.
Oh, Christmassy!
Yay!
Lois Gaiman lives in Harrisonburg, Virginia, and has been listening to the show since June of 2013. She's a podcast fan. I love that.
Yes.
She is doppel employed. She works as a sewing prepper in a sewing shop in Bridgewater, Virginia. That just sounds like it might be a nice town. I've never heard of it, and I've never been there. She also knows how to run the serger.
Serger.
What's the serger?
She'll tell you.
Oh, good. Okay. And she has driven for Uber for the last 6 years. She's a product of our modern economy now. Mm-hmm. She found the show through her ex-boyfriend, now an insignificant other, who insisted that she listen to TMOS. At first, she found the hyena laugh quite off-putting. That's Oscar, I assume, but she grew to love it. Now she enjoys when the hyena mangles the the English language. Yeah. Do some digs at you right away. Her favorite parts of the show are Mike's homepage. Oh, God bless you. Thank you. Let's see. Let me see Mike's homepage. Oscar's scab picking and the daily visit to Soundtown. Her favorite show memories are the birth of little Michael. Oh, I like her. And meeting us at Jimmy's for our book signing. In March of 2004, Lois underwent gastric bypass surgery. Prior to that, her weight was, and you're thin now, 412 pounds. Lois was a tromboner for the Fighting Alice Coyotes, Alice High School of Alice, Texas, and was twice on television with the band for NFL preseason games. And Lois gets most of her life advice from Mike O'Mara.
Yeah! Yes.
Intrigued, you should be. Now here is Lois Gaiman with your beautiful Rudolph antlers on there. Hi, Lois. How are you?
I am doing wonderful good.
That is so cool. I mean, that is just how much weight did you lose when you had the bypass, which 2004, I don't want to say it was brand new, but it was definitely
a younger technology.
Established. How much did you lose when you did that?
Originally, I lost 215 pounds, and because of life, I gained about 80 back, and I'm in the process of getting back down. So, roughly 290 pounds so far.
That's amazing.
That's just amazing, because even with the bypass, even with the body being surgically altered to not require as much food, the experience. I've really never talked to somebody that's gone through that and gone through it successfully. What is that like, and what's the entire experience like? Because I'd love to talk to somebody that's had that done.
Well, originally, when I woke up from the surgery, it was like, did you all actually do anything? Because I had it done laparoscopically, and it was up in Fairfax at one of the Ionovas. And the surgeon was really good. So I really didn't feel a whole lot of discomfort or anything. Not like other surgeries I had had. And when you first start out, you do a couple of weeks of clear liquids, and then you do a couple of weeks of soft foods and that sort of thing. And you progress to different food stages. And so there were times in very, very early on when I felt like I couldn't keep hydrated enough. But other than that, it just didn't seem like all that big of a deal. And then I progressed to solid food, real food, and things got real, real quick.
When you talk about the hydration, I'm sorry to jump in, Mike. I'm curious. Is it because your body, I mean, your stomach is made so small,
you can't take in enough
water to feel hydrated? That must be very frustrating.
That's exactly it. And then once you progress to real food, then you can't drink while you're eating, but you're so used to drinking while you were eating that, you know, it's totally different. And there are times when you can, you know, really upset your pouch, which is what we call the little part of your stomach. Altered part of your stomach,
right?
That it just after a while, it seems like there were times when it seemed like I was, you know, never going to be able to keep food down again.
That's what I've heard, and it's something that it can be painful, I'm told, too, in some cases, if you overestimate what you're taking in.
I mean,
it can be that kind of feeling right in your sternum area. Is that true? I've heard that from people.
Yes. That's exactly true. And it's something that once you've felt it a couple of times, then you get the idea and you back off, and you start to recognize triggers. Like, there'll be a point when I've had like that last bite, and if I take another bite, then I start sneezing, which is totally weird, but lot of people get that. So you learn to listen to your body a lot more than what I used to prior to having the surgery.
Would you, after all you, because it is a process, and mm-hmm. it is a bit of an ordeal to go through. Would you do it all over again? Any regrets of doing it that way?
The only regret I have is that I wasn't able to ever do it sooner.
Okay. All right.
And I mean, there was just, I've been large all my life because of, events in my life. And so I learned early on to eat my feelings for, comfort food and that sort of thing. And so you do kind of give up the comfort food thing, but by golly, life is too short to eat bad food. And so, having my life back and getting used to, being able to move and do things, it's made a huge difference. I don't have diabetes anymore. I don't have sleep apnea anymore. I don't have the hiatal hernia. That was fixed when I had the surgery. There was something else.
I think I want to interrupt you here because I think that when we've all probably watched some of those shows about people who are, so large, morbidly obese, beyond morbidly obese, and you'll see examples of these people that are in their 20s and 30s, and then they're gone. They're no longer with us because they literally can't stop it. I have to share that eating healthy, the biggest difference, Carl and I give ourselves one kind of, we call it a cheat meal a week, but I want to talk about Thanksgiving, where this is the first Thanksgiving in my memory where, because of the way I eat normally, and on the days that I eat 6 of the 7 days of the week, I try to eat. Sometimes I go over, sometimes I'm under, actually. I only eat 2,000 calories a day. And when I'm doing that, I found for the first Thanksgiving in my life, I was like, I feel gross after one serving of Thanksgiving dinner. I was going to ask you, Robb, about, so I didn't know we were going to talk about weight, but since we're on the subject, I think it's fascinating to a lot of people listening. Do you find yourself now, if you ever do, get to that side where you're
carbs,
eating something?
Carbs beat me up, man. I feel like
absolute garbage.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, one little bit of mashed potatoes and some stuffing, and it's like I'm done. You guys do
the
dishes.
Yeah. I was like, ugh. I almost didn't finish it. I was just sitting there, kind of going, it's a strange thing. Yeah, I want to ask you, if it's not too personal, and say I'd rather not talk about it if you don't want to. Getting to that point, when you get to the point of 412 pounds. You said it's a lot of things going on. And if you don't mind, I'm just curious about this because I don't think the reality shows about this really get to it as much. I think there is, to an extent, a genetic component to this stuff. Did you have family members that were also overweight?
Yes. Yeah. My mom struggles with high blood pressure. Diabetes runs up both sides of my dad's family.
Okay.
Both sides of his family tree. And so that was just almost a foregone conclusion that I was going to have diabetes, or somebody in my family was going to have diabetes. So there's a lot of health problems that, I fixed by having this.
That's awesome. Mm-hmm. That is so awesome. Go ahead, Oscar.
Lois, thank you for being so thoughtful and open about this conversation. I think that they're not just members of our audience, but people that maybe don't listen to this show, that when they listen to this, their eyes will be opened as well. Do you mind discussing a little bit of the emotional side how maybe that has transformed from the way?
Yeah, can I dovetail on that? Because I want to go back. You said you were big all your life. So obviously there's bullying when someone is large, and you probably endured. Did you? And so when Oscar brings up the emotional side, I'm curious as to growing up, you probably endured a lot of that, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, for sure. And it got me to the point where I wanted to just you know, hide and be in the background. When I was in high school, I was really, really shy. And the family joke was that I wasn't just the wallpaper. I was the paste on the back of the wallpaper.
Okay.
That's, yeah. I mean, I didn't date all that much in high school. I met my first husband in band. He played trombone, and we would, while the other instrument sections were being drilled because they hadn't practiced, we would kind of hunker down behind our music stands and we'd whisper back and forth. And that's
was
how
he
I
a fighting Alice Coyote also?
Yes, he was.
Alice, Texas. That's yeah. Awesome. Were there, and I like to sometimes focus on the positive of this, because, I mean, there's not enough empathy in the world today. I've always thought that. And people, were there examples of people who showed you kindness and showed you warmth and were outliers from the rest of the gang that can be kind of cruel?
There were always, you know, a few good friends, and I was always kind of, you know, the jokester kind of person when I could bring myself to, you know, step outside my comfort zone. So, yeah, there was always somebody that was trying to help. There was people that would, you know, hey, you need to lose weight. You know, that was always a big thing. My dad's mother, she was, you know, not fat, but she was concerned about me being as large as I was. She did not, she died in 84. So she never, 83. She never saw me at my largest. So, which I kind of felt that as a blessing that she never saw me that large.
And last question about this that I want to ask you, being heavy, because we all go to school with people that that are heavy. Yeah. And what would you tell? I don't know. I'm not putting too much pressure on you to ask this question.
Like there's like when Robb lost his weight, right? Mm-hmm. Like that's a proud moment for us, and he looks great. And thank God he's still funny, but it's just it's one of these things that while we joke about it, you said it earlier within one of your answers that you feel like you're living now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Yeah. Because you feel invisible. And then once I lost about, maybe 100 pounds or so, I felt better. I felt like my not my whole personality, but I just felt better physically. So people would open doors for me and stuff like that. And it was like I was being noticed, and I was felt more valued as a person because of that. And so, you know, it kind of acts as a reinforcement. And so I kind of kept wanting to lose weight, and I haven't reached goal, but it gives me all that much more impetus to reach my goal, which is about, you know, 175, 180 pounds. And I've got maybe 40 pounds to go.
I'm so like this segment is, you know, when I say everybody has a story, everybody has a story. And I just get I get gobsmacked by the quality of our listeners and everybody telling a story. You're so brilliantly articulate the way you share your story. We've burned up your time. Unfortunately, I want to ask you really quick, being an Uber driver, what's the weirdest thing you've seen driving an Uber?
I had to pick up a CPAP machine at a retirement home and take it to a hospital one time.
That's good enough. That's fine. Yeah. That's different.
Well,
that's
and also totally you different. should mention to Mike what you told me in the pre-interview. There is one piece of equipment that you always have in your Uber car now.
Yes. Yes, I do. I have airsick bags in my car at all times.
Oh,
they're
really?
Very inexpensive on that website who shall not be named, but
right. So you pick up a college kid that's a drunky drunk, and you say if you're gonna boot into this.
Yes, exactly. And
oh my god!
You get to the point where you kind of recognize it when they're kind of going, like they're getting into the car and they're going like that for the handle.
Oh god, that's not cool. But thank God they're in the Uber and not in a vehicle. Lois, this has been so much fun talking to you. It's just it's a delight. Congratulations on not only your journey but sharing your journey with. You probably are not even aware of how many people you're going to help by this very conversation here.
Including
to
Mike.
To get people motivated, including Mike.
Yeah.
Shut up, Oscar.
Maybe you
could
get
like
a twofer with the back and the stomach. It would be great.
And look at this. You get to pile on now, too. How the world has changed.
It will change again.
Lois, anybody you want to say hello to before we let you go or anything you want to share with us?
Yeah, I do need to say that gastric bypass surgery is not for everyone.
Okay.
Talk with your doctor and really do your research. So that said, I have to shout out to our military who just remembered Pearl Harbor Day yesterday.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. The Virginia Mennonite Relief Sale and Auction. Look it up on Facebook.
Are you a Mennonite? Are you? Because that's another. You have to come back then and just talk about being a Mennonite.
Okay.
Do you guys make belts or pies?
Pies.
Yes. That's awesome.
My dad makes the best pecan pie you ever tasted.
Oh, I'll be there in 20 minutes.
Yeah. Hello. Well, really a delight. Yeah, go ahead. I interrupted you. Go ahead.
Dick Sanderson, who introduced me to y'all.
He's the insignificant other.
Well, he's still significant. So Mike Harper and Reese Moffitt. I've met them. They seem normal. Jolene White and Mr. GQ, Dirk Vastrick.
Yes.
I hope to meet each of them sooner rather than later. The O'Mara Chicks and TMOS ladies and gentlemen of larger character carriage. And I didn't get a fruitcake this year. I was a slacker. So I do have to say, don't be a slacker like me. Buy the bonus show.
Thank you, Lois. We have to take a break. That is awesome.
Thank you so
much.
Man,
oh, man. Every single time with this
so
talking
sweet.
Head segment, I had no idea. You never know. It's like a box of chocolates. Pardon the reference. You never know what you're going to get.
Moderation, Mike. Yeah. Moderation and chocolates.
Moderation, all things. Thanks for the fat joke, Oscar. I appreciate that. We'll take a break, and we will come back with the homepage
time
right here.
Time and place, Oscar.
Lois's favorite segment coming up next.
This year, spend the holidays with America's favorite family. It's a Cerrito Family Christmas. Featuring the whole Cerrito family. Maureen Donahue Cerrito.
Who wants Christmas cookies?
Jimmy reciting a holiday classic.
Was the night before Christmas and all through the buffalo wing.
A visit from cousin Polly Cerrito.
Forget about it.
The adorable Cindy Lou Cerrito.
Santa Claus, is that you?
And who could forget the tiniest Cerrito? Pony Tim.
God bless us, everyone.
And a special musical appearance by Ozzy Osbourne.
I'm the Prince of Darkness.
A Cerrito Family Christmas is brought to you by the TMOS Holiday Shopping Center. Everything you need to deck the halls, trim the tree, and gifts for the whole family. Shop Target and Walmart by clicking the Holiday Shopping Center banner at MikeOMaraShow.com. And from our family to yours, we wish you
Happy Holidays!
A Merry Christmas, everyone!
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. As the inflation numbers go, so do mortgage interest rates. The recent dip in inflation saw mortgage rates go down as well. The mortgage rates, you got to keep an eye on them.
Yes.
But when I look at all of this stuff with home ownership, it gets confusing. You need some people that can help you navigate. According to my friend Mark Livingstone at Cornerstone First Financial, this is a great time to buy a home. This higher rate environment has led to less competition for buyers and better deals now versus last year. Wherever you are in the home buying process, you need the experts and people you can trust at Cornerstone First Financial. They can help you navigate this housing market. Plus, history proves some prices will hold and ultimately increase through and after recessions. So call now to check out what these guys can do for you, because they are the best. Whether it's a purchase or refinance, call Cornerstone First Financial and do it today. The number one rated mortgage company of all TMOS listeners, 202-625-1221. That's 202-625-1221 or cornerstonefirst.com.
From the four corners of the World Wide Web and into your digital device, it's what you need to know. This is The Homepage.
This is The Homepage, and we start today with Google. Google released their year-end search data yesterday. I always find this interesting.
Yes.
This is what people were searching for most in 2022. You're going to get a lot of this stuff. I'm not going to use a lot of it, but I only use the ones that are kind of cool. We got your people, your actors, your passings, people that have bought the farm, your movies, musicians and bands, songs, athletes, sports teams. Each category has five. I don't have to give them all. What are you guys most interested in? People, actors, passings, movies, musicians, songs, athletes, or sports teams?
I want to start with the passings. I want to know who people are interested about the deaths. Yeah, because that also helps you look over the year and help you remember where we're at.
Number five was Aaron Carter. Number four, Anne Heche.
Yeah.
By the way, did we have the story that they didn't find any
substances
in Anne Heche the other day? Number three was Bob Saget. Number two, Queen Elizabeth. Who do you think was number one?
Gosh, I don't know.
Chrissy
Alley? It's obvious. Betty White.
Betty White. Yeah, I would have thought Betty Queen would have edged her out, but that makes sense.
People, and this was a weird one for me, in general, Arizona gubernatorial candidate Carrie Lake.
Really?
That's just really, really strange. I did it. I Googled it.
Yeah, we didn't know. Well, you didn't know who she was, and you would trail within the election. You didn't know who won, so you wanted to find out who... like who was running?
Yeah, when I Googled, I was looking for vacation destinations, and I said Carrie Lake. That sounds nice.
Carrie Lake, a beautiful town, and everything. Anyway, Antonio Brown at number four, Amber Heard, Will Smith, and Johnny Depp was the top search of 2022. Let's see here, actors. Johnny Depp was also number one there, with Will Smith, Amber Heard, Chris Rock, and Julia Fox. Who the hell?
Oscar?
Julia Fox?
Oh, Kanye's girlfriend?
Yeah, she's the girl in Uncut Gems. She's an actress.
You want to know why he makes the money? I mean, that's his girlfriend, unknown, and she gets
for a cup
number
of coffee.
Five.
Cup of coffee.
Yeah.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Incredible. Let's see. The movies. Number one was Encanto.
Oh, I love Encanto.
Really? I would have thought Maverick was number one.
It's a Disney film. It's a kid's film.
Yeah.
I watched it. My nephew loves it. We watched
it. Let's not talk about
Disney Plus.
Was it? Let's not talk about. Is that song from that?
Raymond. Ronald. I don't even know.
Let's not talk about this segment.
Yes. Oh, this is Oscar's list right here.
What?
Encanto, Thor, Love and Thunder, Top Gun, Maverick, The Batman.
Yeah.
And, here's the one I want to see. Remember we had the critic from
Ty
the Globe
Burr.
On the
Ty Burr.
Everything, Everywhere, All at Once.
Yeah.
Which I have to watch this weekend. I
just
really
watched on Netflix Amsterdam. Star-studded cast, well worth watching. You're
really?
Love it. Yes.
Amsterdam.
Yep.
The TV shows we're looking for on Google, House of the Dragon, Inventing Anna. I watched both of those. The Watcher, watch that. Yep. Stranger Things, you guys love that show. And another one I loved, Euphoria.
That show was so funny.
God. I like that show. Let's see.
Bruno.
Musicians.
Let's talk about Bruno.
Bruno. Yeah.
Number one musician, Adam Levine. Number one song, We Don't Talk About Bruno from Encanto.
That's what it
was. That's one,
There it is. Athletes. I hate that the bad guys go first. Antonio Brown.
Yeah.
Number one Googled.
He didn't walk off the field.
And sports teams. Philly. The Philadelphia
on the
Phillies
athletes list,
number
did
one.
Yaz make it?
Thank you. No, he didn't, but that's kind of
cruel.
He had
to be at number six.
I'll accept that. Still alive. Still
yeah, I'm not saying he's dead. I didn't Tony Bennett him.
Time Magazine, Person of the Year. This one was pretty much a no-brainer. President Zelensky of Ukraine got the award. The magazine said, Zelensky's success as a wartime leader has relied on the fact that courage is contagious. You can't argue with that man's courage. It spread through Ukraine's political leadership in the first days of the invasion. Everyone realized the president had stuck around. I'm going to be grabbing some tickets, I think, for January of the Ukrainian Symphony Orchestra that'll be coming to Southwest Florida. And I dumped it on my son today. So would you be interested in going to see the musicians from Ukraine who are going to perform? And he said, oh, absolutely. That's what he said. That's exactly what he said.
Have you heard
absolutely.
Them?
Absolutely. No, I haven't.
They're a very good band. It's amazing how good they are.
You're an ass.
17 days for Christmas.
Oh, 17 days, Mike.
17.
That's all.
That one I saw coming a mile away.
Sometimes you play it easy like that.
Hi. Did you hear what the man said? What? Only 17 shopping days left till Christmas.
That's it.
He's phoning it in.
So, you know. David Letterman traveled to Ukraine in October to interview Zelensky. It'll be on My Next Guest Needs No Introduction. The episode drops this coming Monday, so check that
out. Now, if for some reason President Zelensky cannot serve in that capacity as Man of the Year, as a backup, Time has the kid who loves corn all lined up to put on the cover.
Corn,
it's
very, very exciting. Shark Week on Discovery Channel is too white.
White?
And we're not talking about just great white sharks. A shark researcher named Lisa Whitenack led a study that looked at hundreds of Shark Week shows. This is funny.
Yeah.
From 1988 to 2020. And it found that the experts who appeared on those shows were overwhelmingly white men. Not only that, this is great, but strangely, a large number of them were named Mike.
Oh.
In fact, there were more white guys named Mike on these shows than the total number of all women with any name. They also found that the shows emphasized negative messages about sharks and lacked useful information about shark conservation. Discovery declined to comment on the study because it, quote, has yet to pass any scientific approvals.
Well, so we had didn't they have Michael Phelps swimming against the shark?
Well, it was virtual. Yeah.
Another Mike.
Mike.
You know
Mike.
What? I think White Guys Named Mike would be a good podcast.
Yeah.
White Guys Named Mike.
Yeah.
But they're not
all
right. White.
All right. Call Mac and tell him I'll do a show with him. An Olive Garden manager in Overland Park, Kansas, sent a long email to employees. This one's for you, O. I want to see what you think. We might be on the same page. He threatened to fire anyone who called in sick more than once this month. But instead, she got canned by corporate. The full message she sent is long. Here are the highlights. She started by saying, quote, call offs are occurring at a staggering rate. From now on, if you call off, you might as well go out and look for another job. We're no longer tolerating any excuse for calling off. But the next line is what really got her in trouble. Here's her quote. If you're sick, you need to come prove it to us. If your dog died, you need to bring him in and prove it to us.
Wow.
She added, if it's a family emergency and you can't stay, you can't say too bad, go work somewhere else. If you only want morning shifts, too bad, go work at a bank. She said, if anyone calls out more than once in the next 30 days, they will not have a job. Then she bragged about how she's never called in sick in 11 years, even when she was sick. Questionable for the food business. Quote, we strive to provide a caring and respectful work environment. This is corporate. For our team members. This message is not aligned with our company's values. We can confirm we have parted ways with this manager.
This is 100% against what they teach you as a restaurant manager, as a kitchen manager. I've taken the class. You keep sick people out of the kitchen.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
So that's not and so really the new motto is.
But it sounds like she's got a restaurant full of slackers too.
Well, the new motto, Mike, is when you're here, you're dysfunctional family.
May I give counterpoint?
She also was fired, but she got all the breadsticks she can eat. Go ahead.
I think we all know this, Mike. In this day and age, you have to be thoughtful. You have to be accommodating with such a tight labor force. Mm-hmm. If you're going to make moves, you have to document and then execute.
Yes.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. So specific employees that are doing
it. Right.
Yeah, and you just and then
you can't just say burn in hell, I'll see you at 8 in the morning.
That's right. And here we go. MATTBLU.
Corporate Oscar speaking right there. How do you really feel about her? You 100% say, behind her?
There was a better day in corporate America where you could send one of these and then people would come into work. Bottom line.
Yeah. There you go. Amen. And
with,
now a little
with or without a dead dog.
Yes.
A 37-year-old Isla Mirada man. That's a beautiful, beautiful area of the Keys. He stole six electric toothbrushes. Oh, by the way, this is one of your three joke kickers.
Oh, I love a three joke kicker.
We're ready.
He stole six electric toothbrushes from Walgreens in Marathon, Florida, and he was arrested Monday morning. Deputies responded to the Walgreens around 10:40 a.m., where employees and witnesses said a man walked out of the store with six electric toothbrushes without paying. He added that he was driving a white Lexus. Deputies identified the man as Tracy J. Mofield. They located the Lexus nearby, driving along the highway. Mofield sped away. Officers didn't pursue because if you're down in that part of Florida, you got your two lanes and it's not a real safe area to do a pursuit. So he split. They let him go. Later, the car stopped on one of the bridges. That's where the cops approached him. He admitted to stealing the items and stated he threw them off the Long Key Bridge. But he was taken in and taken to jail and charged with larceny. I wonder if police did a cavity search.
Ah!
cops did not say if this was his first brush with the law.
Toothbrushes,
get it? Yeah, not as good. They all get worse. The arraignment is set for next week when the judge will hear oral arguments.
Okay, thank you. That. Thank you very much.
They,
we just got to restack them. That's all.
When they all reshuffle. Suck, you put three, and you get quantity over quality. We'll take a break, and we will come back with more fun and more thrills. There is a new artificial intelligence app out there, and we're going to talk all about it and my daughter's wonderful pictures.
Feeling stressed, anxious, or nervous? 4 out of 5 doctors recommend the latest bonus show as the panacea for what ails you.
This is our bonus show.
Yeah.
This is where we do therapy, okay? Yeah. And I can tell you secrets that you wouldn't know on the regular show.
Yeah, it's not all happy, happy, happy. We're successful, right?
This is where I sound like an old fart.
Yeah.
I just want to be an alt-rock DJ.
I'm a Toys R Us kid. You know, my sister was a special ed teacher.
And that's why you turned out so well.
I'm not a monster.
The TMOS bonus show is that happy place where you can escape from the daily pressures that bog you down. Unwind with a subscription today at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
You just made my effing day.
That's wonderful. Sometimes I don't appreciate you, Rob, until after the promo. That's why I turned out so well. Rothy's shoes, cool, versatile, and most of all, comfortable. You will definitely get compliments. There's the driving loafer.
The driving loafer. I love it.
Rob is demonstrating to you. You'll definitely get compliments when you wear Rothy's.
Wonderful.
Even better, Rothy's just launched an all-new men's shoe called the Monty.
Oh, Monty.
It's an effortlessly...
Monty.
There it is. He got it. it's like a cross between a dress shoe and a sneaker.
Yes.
That you can wear absolutely everywhere this holiday season. They also have two new sneaker styles, the RSO2, a more relaxed lace-up that's like a t-shirt for your feet, and the City Slip-On sneaker. That's a refined luxe slip-on with a roomier fit. To top it off, Men's Health named the RSO1 sneaker one of the top 3 sustainable sneakers during their 2022 Sneaker Awards. And if you're looking for some gifting inspiration for friends, family, or your lover, Rothy's has you covered with shoes, bags, and accessories for both men and women. And remember, it's all recycled material and it's 100% machine washable. This season, find out why people fall hard for Rothy's with new shoes, bags, and more for everybody. Everybody loves somebody sometime. You can snag something for yourself or something for someone you love. For a limited time, get $20 off your first purchase at rothys.com/TMOS. That's $20 off at rothys.com/TMOS. Before
Monty,
we get to
Monty.
Before we get to Oscar's app of the day, I have to share with you that I did go to see my my doctor yesterday.
Yeah.
The back guy.
He said, doctor.
Yeah, I did. It happened like I thought. He's sending me out to get an MRI, maybe a little PT.
Fun.
And then we'll see
that
what goes.
Bit.
Yeah. It's a,
make
it's
sure
a journey.
It gets approved before you show up.
It's a journey. I'll see what happens. So the thing is, I go in yesterday and I just was in the mindset of these people probably deal with a lot of bitchy people. I did this when I had some issues before, when I went into a medical facility where they obviously looked haggard and tired and they were dealing with a lot of people in pain. That can be a strain on the people that work there. So I was super charming and I was Mr. Charm and I chatted up the nurse that checked me in. I chatted up the two ladies at the front desk. I chatted up the lady that took my x-ray.
Any prepared shtick or was it just off-the-cuff pleasantry?
just pleasant, just pleasantness. I was wearing my New York Giants shirt, as you guys remember yesterday. Yes. Got some football talk with one of the nurses. The lady that took the x-ray actually came down the hallway after I was in there to show me her Christmas tree because I showed interest and I was talking Christmas with her and how I like their decorations And at the very end, one of the greatest moments I've had in a long time. The door was bare. She showed me right to the door, this nurse I was talking to, and the door was barely closing as I'm walking down to the elevator, and I hear, he was so cool. And I hear that as the door. Hey! She's talking to the two ladies at the front desk.
That's so sweet.
And I was like, yay. However, during my chat with these ladies, it came up that I do a show, that I'm an old radio guy, and we do a podcast that's very, very good, and I describe it, and I do that all the time. I'll tell people, listen to the podcast. I said, well, you can get the app. And the mistake I made was that I said it's also on YouTube, and I brought it up on YouTube. And on YouTube, each and every day, we share a title with the show. Do you want to know, with two nurses looking on, what the title of our show yesterday was, Robb Spiewak? Because you wrote it.
No, no, no. You wrote it.
Well, I wrote it, but he put it in. Yeah, okay. I take ownership.
Yeah.
Wasn't sell my panties.
Sell my panties, yes.
Sell
my with an
my
exclamation
panties.
Point, I believe.
With an exclamation point.
Yes.
With a picture of my fat ass and underneath, sell my panties.
Yes.
He's proud, super proud.
He's so cool.
He's so cool. He's got a website that says sell my panties. So embarrassing. But Oscar, let's talk about the internet. What's going on out there?
Okay. So first, let me be clear here.
Thank you.
That AI is still new to this world, artificial intelligence.
Oh.
There is, and you'll probably see it in your feed here in the next few weeks. And if you see it right now, great. One, there's a new app called, Lensa, L-E-N-S-A AI, which your daughter has a photo of. It'll take your picture and make a beautiful artistic rendering of your image.
Free app?
Absolutely stunning pictures of my daughter.
It is free, but you have to pay for certain aspects of the app, like anything else, right? In app purchases.
Okay.
Two, the other one is, this one blows my mind because I don't understand or even want to feel like I have a better grasp on AI than anyone else. I'm just learning about it now. It's a Elon Musk product. It's an open AI, and it's a program called ChatGP, if I'm not mistaken. I'll get it right in a second. But I have some audio here that I'll explain to our audience from TikTok of what AI essentially does and what this program can do.
Okay.
And I'm going to play it now. Just kidding. What? Oh, maybe I could get it right. Okay, I'm playing it.
All right.
It's not working on your end?
We're plugged in. We're potted up.
Okay, this guy's playing. There we go. Play, 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 play. God damn it.
It's buffering.
Damn it.
Remember,
no, it's
that
not buffering. I loaded the video.
It was a great painkiller buffering.
To you.
Oh, Catherine didn't put her pictures up on Facebook. She put them up somewhere else, maybe Instagram.
So. Yeah, well, I think I saw them on the gram.
I didn't click on it because I didn't want to be a pervert, but I definitely saw it. Okay, now let's see if it'll play.
Okay.
That's there.
Now, what are you playing? Or what are you trying to play?
It's an explanation of what AI can actually do, and it just doesn't want to play here. I can play it off my phone because I know that will work. And it just really, it's shocking to me that this is actually possible, where you can talk to a computer and it will do a great job.
To rewrite the to be or not to be speech for a kindergartner. Want to hear it? To be or not to be, that's the big question. Do we just sit around and feel bad, or do we do something about it? Death is just sleeping forever, but sometimes we dream when we're asleep, and that can be scary because we don't know what will happen. So we put up with all the tough stuff in life because we're afraid of what's coming next, afraid of the unknown. But fear makes us all chicken, and we miss our chance to be great because we're too scared to take a chance.
So this gentleman asked,
is that taking the Shakespeare speech
and within seconds spit out
and
a 5-year-old version?
That's amazing.
What an amazing way to interpret Shakespeare for actors.
Yes.
You can take that and then go back and do that. That's awesome.
Yes.
I love that.
But what you can also do is ask it questions like, hey, can you give me a better example of what AI is?
Okay.
And then it'll give you an example. And if you don't like that example, you can, instead of Googling this, you could actually use this software and say, can you give me a real world example of how AI is used. Okay. And it'll give you that example. It's so much so people are actually talking to this AI in real time online and how the AI is answering. And I'll give you an example.
Like it's having, they're having a conversation with it?
What should I call you? One YouTuber says, what should I call you? Mm-hmm. And they said, well, I don't really have a name. Was like, and then the person writes, well, I would like to give you a name so it feels like we're having a conversation. The bot writes, how about Aurora so I can shed some light on what an AI bot is? And then she goes, okay.
It's almost scary, yes. Isn't it?
Not even almost. She writes, it is scary.
Okay, Aurora. What? And then she writes, what can I call you for short? Like, is there a nickname? She goes, what about Rory?
Oh, my God.
And you see this in real time coming up. And
is it done by text? Or is it done by voice recognition?
And it just it's done by text, but it appears right on the screen. This conversation lasts for 30 minutes. And one of the greatest, takeaways for me was when this YouTuber asks Aurora, the AI interface, if she feels any feelings or feels or yearns to be feeling something. And the bot, this effing computer says, I don't think I'll ever understand what it's like to feel emotion. But I will say that maybe in the future, I will yearn to understand what it feels like to feel.
I don't like that. I do that's not like
scary.
It.
No, that's scary. No. That is so right? scary. That is. What's it called again? It's,
Give me two seconds. Okay. As you go to break.
Oh, you're going to try to do
it. Let me pull
now.
It up. All because right. it's so new. It literally came out 2 days ago. It's open AI from Elon Musk. It's one of his startups, right?
Oh, that
but
guy.
It's Him. Called ChatGPT. ChatGPT.
No punctuation, just one
no
word.
Punctuation.
ChatGPT.
Yeah. Artificial intelligence through a chatbot, and it blew my mind, but it blows anything else I've seen about AI in the past.
Especially if you want to talk to Rory.
Correct. But this is what's crazy.
Open AI, ChatGPT, optimizing language models for dialogue.
Yes. You could ask.
We trained a model called ChatGPT, which interacts in a conversational way. The dialogue format makes it possible for ChatGPT to answer follow-up questions, admit its mistakes, challenge incorrect premises, and reject inappropriate requests. Are you on it right now?
No, I'm not. My interface isn't working right now. I am on it as we speak.
It says try ChatGPT.
Yes.
Right, this screams to me.
Sign up. I can't do that, yes. Right? I want to ask it one question.
What question?
Was the 2020 presidential election legitimate? In the break, we'll do it. I want we'll that question okay. answered when we come back. Perfect. Let's do that, okay?
Got it.
We will come back with more fun and more thrills. You, ladies and gentlemen, are listening to the Mike O'Mara Show. And we'll come back with the answer to that question from a robot.
Inquiring minds want to know, Mike.
Amen. We'll be right back, everybody.
Hey, come here. Buy from Vince's Diet Warehouse and get free gumballs.
Anybody can sell you what they think you want, but if you need new tires for your ride or the sweet, satisfying pick-me-up of a gumball, you can't miss shopping online through the shopping center at MikeO'MaraShow.com. Target and Walmart has what you're looking for. Have it shipped to your door or pick it up at the store. You can't lose because you help support TMOS. And here's something else to chew on.
Gumballs and tires, he can't miss. Trust me. Get out of there.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. I'm holding up the bottle of Dadgrass gummies right now.
It's not as full as it was last week.
Classic formula right here. The flavor, blackberry ginger, absolutely delicious. There's no need to stress over the holidays this year. Dadgrass now has something for everyone. 'Tis the season to indulge, so let Dadgrass help you chill out and enjoy the Yuletide ride. Dadgrass is legal, organic, smokable hemp that relaxes your body and mellows your mind. Their 100% organic pre-rolled joints and flower are very low in THC and high in CBD. So you can enjoy the effects of CBD while keeping a clear head. Try their CBD tincture drops or the newly launched that I just showed you, CBD gummies and flavors like blackberry ginger, good time hibiscus lime, and nighttime midnight berry. That sounds like a dadgrass flavor. Nighttime Midnight Berry. Chill out without getting stoned. Plus, dadgrass didn't forget your furry friends.
Woof.
They also just released a CBD dog bone gummy. No, it's a dog bone. It's not a gummy. Everyone in the house can enjoy, whether you're looking for a buzz.
I just saw Santos with a bag of Funyuns.
Very
He's
exciting.
Loving.
Chill way to enjoy an old favorite. Dadgrass will leave you in a euphoric mood. It's out of sight. By the way, Robb, both of us did it during this commercial. There's nothing they like more at Dadgrass than old farts making old pot jokes that are very tired and stale. All Dadgrass products are federally legal for ages 18 and over, and it ships right to your door anywhere in the U.S. Right now, Dadgrass is offering our listeners 20% off your first order when you go to dadgrass.com/TMOS. Go to dadgrass.com/TMOS for 20% off your first order. That's dadgrass.com/TMOS. All right, before we get to Robb changing a tire, I want to get the answer on.
Yeah.
So you got this this website?
GPT. It's on OpenAI. Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. And we wanted to ask it about the 2020 election.
The question is, actually, I'll let Robb read what I asked.
Well, you read what you asked, and I'll be the computer.
In a computer voice.
Okay.
Was the 2020 presidential election stolen?
The 2020 presidential election was not stolen. This claim has been debunked by numerous sources, including federal and state election officials from both political parties, who have found no evidence of widespread fraud. Additionally, numerous courts, including the Supreme Court, have upheld the results of the election. It is important to remember that the integrity of our elections is a cornerstone of our democracy, and baseless claims of fraud undermine that integrity and erode trust in our institutions. It is important to rely on credible sources of information and to refrain from spreading misinformation. Now, can you do a follow-up
That's
question
awesome.
To that?
Yeah, I can ask follow-up.
Okay, follow-up question. Follow-up with, oh, come on.
O-H-C-O-M-E-O-N. Like that?
Exactly.
Oh, my God.
Oh, come on.
Okay, the computer replies instantly.
Okay.
I understand that you may have concerns about the integrity of our elections, but it is important to remember that our elections are run by dedicated public servants who work hard to ensure. Okay, so now reply, blah, blah, blah.
Okay. No, we're not doing that. We're not doing that anymore.
But, Mike, that's how quick it is.
It was instant. Right. As soon as he hit enter, it was there.
One last one before we go, because I'm curious.
Yes.
What country has the highest IQ?
Okay.
That's a good one.
Highest IQ.
What country's citizens have the highest IQ?
What country's citizens?
Yeah. Average IQ. Sorry, I keep modifying the question, but I know it's a robot. What country's citizens have the highest average IQ?
Okay, let me get that real quick. Citizens.
He's correcting his spelling.
I got it. Done.
Okay. It is not appropriate to compare IQ scores of people from different countries, as IQ tests are not standardized against different cultures and may not be an accurate measure of intelligence in all cases. Additionally, intelligence is a complex trait that cannot be accurately measured by a single test, and it is difficult to make meaningful comparisons between individuals or groups. It is important to remember that intelligence is not a fixed trait and can vary based on a number of factors, including a person's environment, education, and experiences. It is important to avoid making assumptions or stereotypes about people based on their country of origin, but I think we all know it's the USA.
You added that.
I did
at
the last sentence. Sorry.
All right, one last question. Yes, what is the richest country in the world?
Thank you. Does anybody have any guess?
I would say it's those crazy Asians because they made a movie about them.
No, I don't think so.
The crazy rich Asians?
I think we're the richest country in the world.
No, it's got to be Saudi Arabia, right?
I don't know. We'll find out.
I think it's Louisiana.
That's not a country, dope.
Hold on a second.
IQ scores, you can't compare them.
This is fun.
It is.
I like this. We ought to have this handy. We ought to sign up for this.
Oh, it's thinking. It's thinking.
It's thinking. It hasn't given me
What is the
response?
Richest country in the world?
Yeah. Maybe I didn't put a question mark, you think?
Maybe.
No, it's thinking. This is actually...
This is the slowest it's been.
This is the slowest it's been.
It's
do it again with a question mark.
It is stewing.
It might make a difference.
Yes.
Well, if it's that dumb that it needs a question mark to know it's a question, come on.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, come on.
Okay. It is difficult to determine the wealthiest country in the world based on a single metric, as different sources may use different measures of wealth. For example, Some sources may consider gross domestic product, or the GDP per capita, which takes into account the total value of goods and services produced in a country and divides it by the country's population.
All right, that's blah, it. Blah, blah. I don't want to hear
a lot of it is
anymore.
A political.
A solid answer.
Yeah, it's valid.
A little too careful. A little too careful
Mike,
for my.
I agree.
But then again, I'm an American.
All three answers what we about, got were careful. They were
what
careful.
What about what is Sophia Gray?
Oh, God. Not again. Sophia Gray, my God.
Becoming a cornerstone of this program.
Well, I think it's new, right?
Yeah.
Question mark? Here we go.
It's thinking.
It's thinking.
I'm sorry, but I'm not able to browse the internet. I do not have information. But then it says I would help if I can.
Hey, put in what is the Mike O'Mara show?
Okay, thank you.
What is the Mike O'Mara show question mark?
Okay. M-E-A-R-A.
Yeah. Show.
Yeah, that's the spelling.
He's new here. It says, what is the Mike O'Mara show? The answer just says, great.
No, stop it. So you stop doing shtick? Can you possibly stop doing shtick?
Mike, I was padding while it was answering. It's the same answer about the last thing. It says it's not able to.
I don't surf the internet. All right.
And I would be happy to help if I could.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. You added that.
What? Right.
No, it says.
I would be happy to help if I could.
Yeah, it says that on the
side.
It's
almost identical, except for they pasted out Sophia
Gray
with the Mike
O'Mara
show.
I don't
want to
ask about your tire. I want to ask about the Netflix Secret Club. What is that all
about? Oh, this is fascinating. I saw this today, and it was in, I believe, the New York Post, and also I got it from another source. There is a secret streaming society that has 2,000 members that Netflix invites you to watch programs and movies before they release and comment on them to alter them before they go wide. It is called
the
Preview Club. Yes. It started in May of 2021 as an attempt to get feedback on its content. And do you remember that show, that movie Don't Look Up?
Yeah.
That was one of the first movies they put out in the Secret Preview Club. And invariably
that's the Jordan Peele, right?
No, it was I don't know if it was Jordan Peele. It was the one about the meteor and the president. It was
which one?
Oh, Don't Look Up
Yeah, with DiCaprio and Meryl Streep was the president.
Yeah, right.
And they said that it wasn't funny enough.
And Jennifer Lawrence.
Yeah,
right?
And they went and re-edited it to make it funnier before they went into wide release. There's only 2,000 people that have been part of this club. Netflix,
is Up the one with Jordan Peele? Is Up the...
No.
What the hell is his... What's his most recent horror movie?
The one that just came out with the cabin?
The one where they're all out and they're... They're getting meteors that rain down upon them, for Christ's sake.
I'm going to give it to you now. Give me a second.
God damn it. Nope.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. But here's the amazing thing. Since they've come out with this and it's been released, the details are sketchy because everyone who joins this club has to sign an NDA.
Yeah.
So it's starting to show up on Reddit and things. But since
this
reminds me of that screener club that when you would get screeners.
Well,
when he was part of the
being
Academy.
The Screen Actors Guild.
But Amazon Prime Video has a similar program.
When I paid my dues.
Amazon Prime Video has a program called Amazon Preview, and Hulu has something called the Hulu Brain Trust.
Ooh.
So these secret societies of screeners are out there and existing, but now we're just finding out about them. And I would love to be a part of them. NDA.
Is your Murders in the Building show exclusively Hulu?
Yes, it was made for Hulu. And I believe, I think it was a knockoff or a reimagining of a British show that was called
and
Only
what's
Murders
the Hulu group called?
This is called the Hulu Brain Trust.
I thought it was Hulu Hoopers.
Brain Trust. Maybe if I was in that, I could have prevented that show from going to air.
Why do you hate it so much?
I don't. I'm just busting.
Because it's nerdy.
It is a little nerdy.
It's a
dork show.
It's
the dork show.
And you know what?
That should be a name of your podcast, the dork show.
That's right. Well, that would be misinterpreted by other.
Who would be your first guest on the dork show?
The dork show?
Who
would have to be a long monologue? I think it would just be me.
That's the right answer.
And then you could get like a send off of the Marilyn Manson. So we are all part of the dork show.
Yeah. We are part of the dork show. And then join me next week when I'll be joined for 3 hours with Mark Riddell.
Good answer. We gotta take a break. When we come back, the dork will have town sound.
Dorktown.
The dork show.
And you know what? You gotta give credit to your wife. She's the first one to really call me a dork and make it stick.
Well, that was after she called me a dork, so you should take solace in that.
I do.
We will.
She has a type.
And we will come back with more fun right here. Soundtown on the Mike O'Mara Show.
How are you? Hope you're enjoying a very romantic holiday season. It's your favorite president. Yep, sitting before a roaring fire on a bearskin rug, and all I got on are my Duluth Trading Company fat shorts. Just wanted to take this opportunity to say this holiday season, spend it with someone you love. Get close. Hug them. Kiss them. Schmooze them. Yeah. Bill Clinton saying happy holidays to you and yours.
Why are you running away, dear?
I'm sorry. That's Hillary. She's got some marshmallow in her beard.
What's going on?
What?
What's that? We might have been drinking the day we did
those. This is a fat shorts.
We should probably do one more Christmas session.
I believe so, yeah.
Does your lawn have weeds, bare patches, or pet spots? Sunday, remember that name. They can help you solve all these problems the easy way before the real dead of winter rolls around. They got everything you need from fertilizer to seeds to weed control, and it's all delivered right to your door. I used to hate it. The whole process was such a drag when you're trying to fertilize your lawn and get out there. I didn't know what I was doing. Now I look forward to it because Sunday's lawn care products are quick and they're easy, and you don't even have to go to the store. Sunday's custom lawn care is the best. You just go to getsunday.com. You put in your address, and their lawn analysis tool does the rest. They use soil and climate data to create a personal nutrient plan delivered to your door right when you need it. Sunday's lawn care products are made with good stuff, stuff that you can feel good about. Seaweed, iron, molasses. You're not putting any poison in there.
Poison.
Best of all, it really works. I've used it. I know. Trust me. Full season plans start at just $129, and you can get 20% off at checkout when you visit GetSunday.com/TMOS. That's 20% off your custom plan at GetSunday.com/TMOS. And thank you. And now, the Town of Sound.
Sound. Sound.
Sound.
Sound.
What was that for? Like, what would you call that for?
We call this stereophonic sound.
Sound Town.
It was a little Gene Simmons-y.
It sounded like the sheer panties guy.
Sheer panties. There's nothing quite like sheer panties. Yes. Perhaps, maybe we can do a really dirty promo for
And I'm gross.
No, wasn't there like some movie or some...
He's speaking of Al Adamson.
When he's like the Al Adamson trash cans.
Oh, that was a different guy.
Oh, different guy?
Yeah, I thought you were referring to the naughty stewardesses.
Oh, or
the
naughty.
She's, naughty stewardesses.
She's the naughty cheerleader.
What's the one you're playing with fire?
Oh, with Females for Hire.
Females for Hire.
They used to send the commercials out on 45 RPM records.
You're playing with fire with Females for Hire. They will do anything you want them to do. All right, that's it.
All right,
I can't do
change,
that
clean the palette.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Thank you. Monty.
Oscar was all over the internet last night. He was sending stuff.
What were you
left
doing
right.
up? Were you going to bed at 5:44?
No, I woke up with some heartburn around 3. So then I was up for a good half hour.
What did you eat that brought on the heartburn?
You know. Some bowl that my wife made. Who knows?
Some bowl.
Yeah, because there's grapes, right? Grapes are acidic.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah,
especially,
so,
and she puts yogurt on. That's more acid.
Chicken and grapes.
A lot going on. And
what, Pony?
She does chicken and grapes.
Chicken and grapes.
That's her favorite.
Chicken and grapes.
That's what you chose to open the mic for? Nothing about the printer?
F off, Rob.
You're playing with fire with chicken and grapes.
And I was on TikTok, and sometimes I will send Rob some Soundtown clips.
He does, but yes. I can tell when he's bored because they go, bing, bing.
But they
bing.
Don't wake you up, do they?
No.
Yeah, I know your phone's not next to
you. It was a very lovely little video of Sofia Vergara cleaning on vacation.
That's the one I didn't pull.
Yeah, that's a different one. That wasn't good for Soundtown.
No, but this was okay. This is a guy, and he's a TikToker called Papa Judy, who plays... I don't even understand. Maybe Oscar can shed some light on this. It says, "Don't bother me. It's laundry day."
Yes.
And then in the apartment of these millennials, there's clothes everywhere.
This is great. This...
And he goes up to surprise his girlfriend with a merry prank.
Yeah. So he's pranking his girlfriend. And what I thought worked, because what I like to do is I like to close my eyes and listen to it and see if it works, is their value system in this house visually is just like a destroyed house of just... not millennials, Gen Zers.
Gen Zers, forgive me.
Yeah, so younger
than us.
He walks around the corner and says this.
Okay.
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No!
Yeah, they haven't done. They haven't done.
Play it again. Play
they
it
haven't done
again.
Wash in a year and a half. But this matters.
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No.
Such a loser.
Did
she say anything else?
No, his girlfriend's value system. Oh my. This is what crushed her world.
Yeah. That's absolutely what matters.
That was it.
I have a question. Since Oscar sends you that stuff,
yeah,
I want you to approve this on the air if you want. Would you be averse to people sending you? Like the
no,
internet
not
is so
at all.
Vast
people,
and
people
so
have been sending
wide.
Me stuff for 10 years, and I love.
Where do you
when
want
them
to
it.
Send it? Where do? You, but we never promote it, so I think it would be a good idea for
Robb,
you to get stuff.
Robb at MikeOMaraShow.com, and
if
I
you
guarantee
see
you, I'll look at it. Yeah,
that
yeah.
you think would sound good on the audio.
Sure.
The Soundtown. Send it to Robb. Yeah. Okay?
Send so it to Dorktown.
Dorktown. No, it's Robb with two B's at MikeOMaraShow.
Yeah, that's right.
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No.
All right. She's not dead, by the way.
She's not.
It was a merry prank.
Clarify.
Of course she's not.
Mike, a man was on trial in Michigan for being a racist and disturbing the peace. He's just an all-around bad egg. And because of modern regulations, he was being tried via Zoom. And I love the take that this judge has describing what's going on with the guy that's being
I want the record to reflect that while the court has muted the defendant's microphone at the Oakland County Jail, he appears to be yelling and pointing at the camera. And now he has removed his pants to show the court his backside. So I'm putting him in the waiting room.
So he moons
the court.
Yes.
On Zoom.
And so what does she do? She puts him in the waiting room.
Not a lot of remorse in the waiting room.
It's the same thing we do with a talking head.
How did he react when he was told about Kylie Jenner, though?
Oh, he's...
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No!
It was visceral and guttural.
Meanwhile, on TikTok, there's a guy named Lucas DeScaper. And he was at, this was actually posted yesterday. Oscar sent this as well. He's looked like he was in a kayak.
Yeah, he's
maybe.
In a kayak.
And
feet out, like not in, like the sit on kayak.
And a great white shark gets so close to him. This is the reason why this works on Soundtown. Two reasons. When you hear the water being displaced, like the splashing, that's the shark cutting through the water.
Great white.
And it looked to be like a 12, 14
just
feet.
Massive.
And and when he says, what should I do? Listen carefully to the advice his friend gives him.
Dude, Danny.
Yeah.
What do I do? Holy s***. Holy s***.
His friend Danny says, film it.
That's all he says.
That. Yeah.
That's all he says.
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No!
But listen again. When you hear that water sloshing... That's the shark going by with the.
I turn
the
it up a little. Bit.
Okay. Turn it up, really turn it up.
Dude, Danny.
Yeah.
What do I do?
Holy
shit!
Film it.
I just sent it to you, Mike, so you have reference.
It's
it is wild,
striking,
wild.
a lot of times they make a big deal about people who audition for Saturday Night Live and didn't get it, and one of the most famous people that auditioned and did not get into Saturday Night Live was Jim Carrey. Shortly after he got picked up by In Living Color, but Saturday Night Live turned him down. He says he kind of had a bad feeling about the audition going in. This is a true story of when he was going into Rockefeller Center.
My name is Jim Carrey, and this is my Saturday Night Live audition. The day I was auditioning for Saturday Night Live, I got out of my car and I heard a voice say, "Don't jump!" And I looked up at the top of the building, and there was an NBC page standing on the logo trying to get the nerve up to jump off and kill himself. And I went, "This is not going to happen."
Not a good omen. When the man when a man is trying to commit suicide when you're going into your audition.
Wow. Did he say whether the guy actually did it?
No, he never mentioned it.
He's selfish actor.
And let us close with this.
Right.
Another TikToker. We are TikTok rich today. And this comes from Shannon Zabios.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah.
Group effort.
This is a lady. Her name is Brittany Smith. And she does a lot of little videos where she plays a representative of the southern part of these United States. And in this one, if you just glance at it, it looks like she's smoking a cigarette and talking on a cell phone. But if you look closely, the cigarette is a crayon and the cell phone is a Capri Sun. So she's just pretending and she's talking about Meemaw.
Brenda, what you doing? Well, I was calling to give you a little heads up. I just had to go pick up Meemaw from the Piggly Wiggly. And it turns out we ain't welcome down there no more. Like none of us. Well, she went down there in her house coat with no drawers on again, but that's not the issue. According to Meemaw, she was on the bread aisle and her stomach hit her. She said she started heading to the bathroom and she caught the walking farts, and she said she knowed it was too late then. Yeah, Tammy said that she left a little trail of rabbit turds all the way to the bathroom. And believe it or not, that's not the biggest issue. One of them little youngins in there picked up one of them turds because he thought it was a Hershey Kiss, and he ate Meemaw's turd. Listen, they shut down the whole store. They called the ambulance, the fire department, and poison control. Who, Meemaw? No, she's all right. I host Rolf in the front yard, gave her a beer, and she's in there taking a nap. She's a little embarrassed, but she'll be all right. I told her next time she'll stick some drawers on to catch them turds. I can't tell you how many times I tell her before she leaves this house to make sure she's got on her drawers and a bra. All right, holler at me if you need anything. Rusty, do you put him and shut him down?
And Mike, that is all I have.
Wow. Wow. Thank you, guys. Wonderful today. Good stuff. Thank you, Shannon. Thank you, Oscar. We appreciate that. We'll be back with our fabulous bonus show. No.
No.
That's right. We'll be back tomorrow with a brand new bonus show. I hope you're there for us. We appreciate it. And if you haven't gotten the bonus show, you know, be like our friend Lois Gaiman.
Yes.
All right. Get the bonus show, please.
Support, please.
Lois gets it.
Yes.
It's responsible for well over 200 pounds of weight loss. Our bonus show. That's what did it for Lois. Let it do it for you. That's it. We got to get out of here. For Robb Spiewak and Oscar Santana, Mike O'Mara saying so long, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Want more? Make sure you check out the Mike O'Mara bonus show. Get it at MikeO'MaraShow.com.
Kylie Jenner dead at 24.
No!
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.